Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to this ongoing video series here on the Lord Master channel, the Sognsdal Saga, as it is called, which in the last episode, which we focused mainly on the early stages of the colonization of Greenland, which obviously we're still quite a long ways from switching from the next phase from settlement to hopefully integration rather than subsistence. But I found out it's actually marginalization is the one that you got to avoid the most. Just integration would make our lives easier, and subsistence will make things a little harder up there. As I've mentioned all of that during the past two episodes of how everything works regarding the colonization of Greenland and all that. But there's going to be a little bit of an increase of subsistence that will be coming soon, unfortunately. But it's only for this greater goal that we must accomplish, and that is the unification of Norway. It will finally happen. This will happen on this very decade that we're on. We know that Jorvik is out there fighting a war which they're looking to get the one last remnant of an independent petty kingdom of Cornwall. And I even noticed that, oh, I remember you. You used to live in Nordland, which is over there when we conquered it. So you became a Viking exile and launched an adventure attack and took over Brittany. While France down there is dealing with an independence revolt down there. As much as we would like to raid them, but we would be wasting our time. Although only Smarlund in Gilteland are the only ones out there that are not yet part of Zurich, Sweden. Now, anyways, I would also say that it would be best to unite Norway now. But to do that, we must fight one more war. Because you need 16 out of 30, and we have 14. Vestfold will be the next target. Even though, despite the fact that we have improved relations, have a common friend, and all that, not to mention attracted to me, but we need those lands. Not for myself, but to be part of the realm. He's got a war horse of his own, claims to have divine protection, nine soldier morale, mounted exercise. Well, we're going to conquer your land and you will also become a Viking exile, and who knows where you're going to go. But one thing's for certain, the land that you own will be ours. And I do mean ours, my family. Speaking of which, as it's been a while, my father's still doing fine health-wise. My mother is fine. Rinjolfa, as he has only two daughters, which I'm sure he'll get a few more in the coming years. Gita's recently married, which told him to marry this berserker who's a Herculean, which I admit is probably, you know, the best option for him. Togir, who we don't hear much about him, even though he is compassionate, patient, and cynical, despite the education having two commander traits. But he hasn't really been doing much of anything, and there's a reason why you don't hear much of a fuss about him. So that's why, prior to this recording, I went to find a spouse, and I think we found the right woman for him, even though she's going to be of a different culture and faith. And it kind of adds up to my curiosity as well. And of course, still betrothed to this neighboring area up there. But we might have to call him in as an ally, knowing that... Actually, no. I thought they were allied with Jordvik. Must have ended that alliance for whatever reason. But... that means, well... this is why it is the best time to do that now. But before we do that, here's another thing that's also ongoing. Oh, inspiration project. This woman here, very competent at craft, she's forging regalia for me as I do not have it. And also we're trying to fabricate a hook on this woman here. This Saxon woman from northern Germany, as we know today. Saxony. She wants to forge a crown. And as you can see on myself, I do not have regalia, nor do I have a crown, and this would be an excellent time to give me those two. I don't have any trinkets yet. And we don't have any court artifacts, which of course, once we form the Kingdom of Norway, we're going to have ourselves our own royal court. And also, I will move the capital. I will soon be leaving the old home of Moskopang. Well, actually, technically, for you those who remember the backstory, we're actually from down here in Sognsdal. That small agriculture community, which is not even listed on the map. But in Moskopang, which has been our home ever since we took it over for 16 years, on the 17th year, we will be moving to Nidaros, because that is the Nidjor capital, and it also has plains, not mountains. As defendable the position is, there's more chance of development up here. And plus, we're currently constructing longhouses up there, which adds more levies, more control, and more prestige. And next time, get palisades. And we better get this war done soon, so we can hold a grand blot, as much as I know who I'm going to sacrifice when that time comes. And then eventually, when we get to 889 again, support Greenland, which in fact, that should be an important decision. That should be reminded every once in a while. Knowing that we all have to play a part in this struggle. House scars are near max, but I think we'll be fine. So there's no need to call our ally in. As much as I'd like to play another board game with you. Okay, it's not till next year. That would play the next game of Hanefital. What is that name again? No. Hanefital. I mean, I had that pronunciation. I mean, I recently learned how to pronounce that Norse board game. So, I'm sure it'll come up again in my mind. So, this is what's going to happen right before we finally declare war. Conquer Vestfold. Upland. This smaller realm. And this other neighboring realm up there. They will all join. We have offer vassalization without having to fight a conquest war over it. Although we may eventually have to fight one more conquest war. Because there's this other part of Norway that is supposed to be part of it. But instead, Uppsala is where that's held there. But the problem is, he's got allies. Lots of them. Including the neighboring ones. Actually, that's part of this. So that'd be quite challenging. But once we get everybody together, we'll actually increase the vassals. And I may increase, you know, I get another men-at-arms regiment. Probably just another of the big men or the Bundy. Should be another one of these. Pop my neck. All right, it's been decided then. And plus, we'll be at full strength with the Huskarls by the time we march over there. Should be. For Vidkin. And those two lands that will be taken, they're not going to belong to me. I will actually give them away to a certain somebody who I believe deserves it, and also would be beneficial for our dynasty. Sensible to a thing, Ástríðr. I accept principles. Your brother Torgir and my acquaintance, Birgit, will be joined in holy matrimony. May their union bring happiness and fulfillment. That's from Vigur of Sampni. Yes, my youngest brother is to be married to a Sami woman, and there's a reason for that. Amazonian. Inheritable trait. Arbitrary and craven of gluttonous. I mean, she's not a good person all in all, but she's terrified, so she won't cause much trouble. Asta, my old friend. You're a mystic now, no longer a wise woman. My vassal Hirsir Absalom. Well met, Leech. Heard tell of your patronage of Morag the Metalsmith. This is his forge of a girl worthy of a Drottning. Please, take this. Give it to her. I wouldn't want to miss the chance to aid in the creation of a masterpiece. He has a reputation for generosity, and it seems he has found a new outlet for his spinning. How generous. Might be a slightly higher quality. See too if we can catch him. Even if we have to fight him up in his turf. Plus, I'm a rough terrain expert. He may have the mountains, but that won't matter. Well, I mean, he does have a bit of advantage, but we are more numerous, and we know how to counter theirs. He does have much in the way of wars, except he's got one good one, and after that, he'll have nothing. Cutting through enemies of ease, I find myself picturing my foes like demons, the unclean that I must smite with holy power. Is this just my imagination? Is it just a drilling, or fear, or some kind of combination of the two? Either way, it feels real to me. Maybe I'm being shown to these demons as a message from the heavens, telling me to use my divine will as a means to strike the enemy down. I continue fighting, in vigor of holy strength as I thunder towards Helgi. Taste my blade, Helgi. He is of that same dynasty as him. I smite the unholy. He strangled their last fighter with his own intestines. My father did that. Fight here again, in his backyard. All gone now. Do your magic. It's got palisade, but it's not gonna take too long. Sven and Magnus are among the most powerful vassals of my realm. I never know how to keep them happy, so they don't go around stirring up trouble. Perhaps flattery is the way to go. Anyone would be pleased to have something made in their name, wouldn't they? And I have just the right thing in the making. Should I let my beneficiary Morag know that I am dedicating a masterpiece to my trustworthy vassals and advisors? Then again, it is my artifact, so maybe I should just, Dedications are overrated anyway. I'd like to think that she is more pious than prestigious. A clash. A legendary holy man. Recently, there's been rumors among the commoners in Odaland that a wise and benevolent holy man by the name of Karoska is going around secretly blessing every town and farm and river and so on, chanting prayers and performing white magic to improve the lives of the people. Such stories are nice and inspire the people, but no one has actually seen this Karl figure. No, no, that's not Karl. I just looked closely. It's Kari. It's got an eye at the end. People just claim that he actually exists. Ofgaard are also unsure what to make of these stories as well. Thought it was Karl. No, it's Kari. It's Kari. It ends with an eye. I'm sure he is real. Stories are circulating in the region about how a selfless and powerful holy person using various forms of white magic helped the locals improve their eyes. However, no one has ever met this person in first person. And many stories about this figure are hard to verify. Helps with the development. If only it was in Nidaros. Future reference. Got to get. Hang on. There we go. That's another thing you gotta be careful. Struggle clashes within Norway. People settling their disputes of whatever it may be. But remember, you're gonna befriend this man from up north, just to keep him safe from another realm of Finnmarker, but they're not going after him. But he's an interloper. Oh, my child. Oh, you treated him well. Okay. That's good. But you know, I thought of something, and I hope he doesn't find out, even though he's my friend. I originally seduced him, man, because I originally hoped that my first child would be a genius. But it's not to be. Asta's talents. Ah, yes, my old friend, who is like the closest thing of having a grandmother to me. Crossing the courtyard, I'm pleased to finally hear someone appreciating my friend Ástríðr. Oh, don't listen to those sour grapes of yourselves and wolves. You're the best Hrixgidia Goloth's log has had in ages, at least that I know of. I knew what I saw was real. Sven won't like that. Well, I got so much money, so why not? Say, let's have a night out. Just us three. Keep your friends close. Most disgruntled vassals. I'll be sure to hold a feast after when the kingdom is formed. I'll be sure to make that happen. That's plus one. Guess he contributed something or whatever. My regalia is about to be finished. Okay, let me see. Occupied enemy, good sake. Occupying counties, 40%. Occupying enemy capital. Captures that. Anyways, I exit my tent. Siege camp sprawls out before me. A chaotic ragtag collection of wagons, tents, and piled high piles of driftwood that the carpenters are burning for firewood. Flags snap and flail in the rain-drenched wind. Shouts and cries ring through the damp air. My loyal retainer approaches and informs me that the siege has ended. I gather my bodyguards and head to the edge of the camp. The Earl of Tunsberg stands before me. Bodies of vultures and crows scattered in front. In the fields between, a vast sickly black cloud of locust swarms. Yellow bands on the hard shell codpieces are swollen to bursting. Shrill rattling sounds fill the air as the acrid smoke swirls above them. Sprawling through the air, the locusts descend upon their kin, stripping them bare and leaving a field of flesh and blood and a hollowed hulk of waste. Unburied bodies are heaped in a gruesome mass grave. Row upon row of arrow-pierced shields mark the outlines of hasty ramparts. Black-veiled women scurry among the scattered buildings, tossing supplies into a crude wagon. Spare it this time. We're not going to do any looting because we make such good income these days. Even if we go out and loot England or Francia or Holland. Stop. Stop the war now. We don't need to continue it. All of this. Get out of here. Now, two things. Actually, we should have not done that, because don't you know they're raiding us? Well, in this case... See? They're raiding. Okay, stop. This is exactly what we need. I'll go take care of this matter. To deal with the raiders before we give away territory. Considering my life's deeds, it is only natural that others should respect me. I am convinced that Jotun Brynjolf also has accomplished a thing or two which fills him with pride. Perhaps I should commission a small poem comparing our deeds to illustrate that we're both cut from the same cloth. Oh, there's no reason for that. Just go with the progress. Focus on his accomplishments. He's got some gold carrying, but I'll be happy to take some of that away from him. There she is, shouts a voice over my shoulder. It's Jotun and Ástríðr, says someone else from another direction. Where are they coming from? I think to myself. Whilst continuously fighting off more and more foes, after a prolonged period of combat, my nearby soldiers desperately try to protect me, but as their numbers dwindle, I begin to take hits from a larger quantity of enemies. At last, my personal guard falls dead on the floor. I look up to see myself surrounded and several at a short distance from the rest of my army. They have me 10-1. I've been wounded. I like those odds. 89% chance that I'll manage to survive and I'll become an aspiring blade master. 10% chance, although unlikely, that I'll die. I like those odds. In the sudden rush, my assailants push me at the same time. Blades and maces ready for the attack. but are all equally unprepared for my own. As a sword dashes in front of me as poised in my abdomen, I slash the head holding the blade off, and in a falling upswing from the same unhanging strike, I send my blade into the hand owner's throat. Parrying another strike with my sword, I dodge under it and collect the blade grasped by a severed hand from the ground and use it to jab into the nearest attacker's eye. I turn to see many other enemies slowly approaching me. Over a short deal of time and two swords at the ready, the ten or so foes soon lay as muddied corpses around me. I wipe the blood from my own blade and leave the other lodged in the original owner's chest. Who's next? Retreating from immediate combat to assess my situation, I notice the damage my body has received. While it's absolutely not lethal, but it is certainly something to be concerned about. Notice my concern, my fighter, Herr Sir Hrothel, hurries over, convinced he has enough training in medical field to give me an emergency situation missed about.
You sure about that?
You better not screw this up. I'm giving you this chance, because it could be anything. I mean, I'll lose some of the stress. So do what you can. He either performs a miracle and I lose wounded, or I get a successful battlefield treatment, or I would become severely injured, thus my prowess goes down a little further, which means it'll take longer to heal. Do what you can. Treatment helps a lot. Thank you. Over here, my lady. Beneficiary Morag weighs me over a wide grin. I have toiled many days and nights, and finally my work is done. She presents me with an object wrapped in cloth. As I lift the fabric, my eyes grow wide. A fancy regalia, very fine craftsmanship. It consists of a brass scepter, set with pieces of jet, and then a cloak that's been embroidered with wool thread, and a large jet cabochon necklace. VIET or Jet, how do you pronounce that? Anyways, prestige up, dynasty opinion up, and some romance scheme power to go along with that. Kind of befits, you know, a woman like her. There you go. Now all I need is a crown. Thank you very much. But at least you got a cat. And I know I got a strong hook, but you can leave whenever you want. You did what you could. We recover the loot. Now we officially disband. I noticed there's a special building here in Tonesburg. Hedelstave Church. Hedelstave Church is the largest stave church in Norway, and it has a beautiful wooden interior. Legend says that the church was built by a mountain troll in merely 3 days. Is that so? But look how much that's going to cost you. Doesn't help much due to the construction slowdown. And you do not have the city planning innovation, so that doesn't matter. Trying to look something up. Well then. Okay, let's just do some reading here. Okay, here's what we're going to do. Before we form the Kingdom of Norway, who wants this land? It's got palisades, it's got sparring grounds. Over there in Oslo, which is where the modern capital of Norway, Oslo, is located. So if I were you, by you, it should be my brother. He deserves it for his long service. He will have these two lands, of Vengelmork and Vestfold, because he's my brother and I needed a vassal that is of my dynasty Especially that someone that supports him, since both of us are of the same dynasty where we have that estate in Greenland, where both of us get to make a little bit of income from that estate. So some of that money Prestige Party goes to me, it should also go to you too, Brynjolfr. So you will be my vassal. He's more of a strategist. In a few years' time, he will become a strategist. And of course, Thorun is no longer my seneschal. Which is fine by me, because I'm sure there's another one who could be better at this, if we need control, which there isn't any right now. Let me see. Actually, wait for all direct vassals to join. This is where it's going to come in. That formation of Norway now. But first, let's move from Laskapanga to Nidaros, which is now 400% control, and in 40 days, a longhouse is to be built. And then we'll build the next building, then that's it for the time being. So this will be our new home. And this is going to be the site where, on this day of July 4th, 884 AD, while we gain 400 prestige for creating this title, where we spend nearly half of our current wealth to create this title alone. But mind you, it's reduced because it's tribal. The Nordvega Court. As Strotsnig, you have new duties and responsibilities. You will now be expected to regularly hold court, solving the disputes of the realm, and letting your courtiers take part in daily routines. Thodmundur is looking sternly at me in direct, almost lecturing way. Perhaps there's some surprise in his eyes. He starts to unfold a beautiful banner, bearing the emblem of House Sognsdal. One of the ways in which the world will now judge your rule is how you adorn and care for your royal court. I've taken the liberty to have this made as a gift to mark the beginning of your royal tenure. Let them see their new Drottning. So there you go. This is what this royal court looks like. But obviously this is a Western European style court. As, you know, even though we're of a northern, you know, culture, but it'll look like that, and all that would make sense. It doesn't look like a longhouse to me, but something that's a bit more rather sophisticated. So we'll put this house banner up here. This is the banner of the Sognsdal House, a symbol of authority of the family and its science. Adds a bit more monthly prestige, renown, and much reduced men-at-arms maintenance cost, as in, you know, prestige, since we're tribal. Really fits, like, based on the shape of the throne, and is that. And now over here, we'll put the dynasty banner here. This is the banner of the Sognsdal Dynasty, a symbol of the authority of the bloodline and all its members. Commissioned by Ástríðr. As if I made this myself. Slightly reduced on building construction costs, while prestige and renown up monthly. And plus one on the court grandeur bonus. But there's more. Regarding the court grandeur, obviously it's at the lowest level. But we can increase that a bit. Get it up to level 1. Knight effectiveness up. Level 2, you bestow royal favor counselor task. And 3 is unlock manage royal guards counselor task. And the army of ours will carry more loot, and the raid speed will be faster. And due to the limits of being at tribal court, I mean, in fact, it says it right here. At court, might makes right. The hall shall be decked with loot and plunder. So, if... I mean, if you were to have a higher level, you would get more dread gain. Not natural, but just the amount you get. And after 12 months, courtiers and guests will gain plus one. Another, after 24, after 36, and another. Courtiers gain the warlike courtier traits, which is character has spent at least 5 years on a rowdy warlike court, populated by warriors and tacticians. But mind you, that's only if the grandeur level is up to a level 5. So obviously we can make some improvements. Outmoded fashion, which it had no effect, but now it'll have a bit more monthly prestige up and court grandeur bonus up for the owner. While courtiers, I guess, will get a bit more prestige here. Courtiers turn heads when they visit towns and cities. Haha! No one looks forward to eating in this court, but it is said the company makes up for it. The feast activity reduces less stress. Well, let's change that to at least modest food. Up the grandeur a bit, and lose a bit more stress. So, guests are well fed with adequate local cuisine. In the lodgings, where there are occasional diplomatic instances when guests are asked to lodge together. We could change that to small lodgings, where guests could stay longer. Guest acceptance to join schemes in my court as an agent. And grandeur bonus up as well. And the court is a guest where completed inspiration quality has a small chance of improvement. And less stress gain. There is space for any courtier to have their own. We have very few servants, which this court's handful of servants are exhausted, meeting every guest. Now there will be a few more servants. So the court has servants that can provide almost every crucial comfort. So, guest recruitment costs reduced, personal scheme power up, hostile scheme resistance up, grandeur up again, and courtiers and guests, their personal scheme power is up, same for the resistance. So this is the best we could do, as we make pretty good income and we can afford all that. And it can only go as far as level 3 unless certain events. As well as getting more court artifacts just to increase the grandeur around here. So there you have it. Look at this. This view, the throne view here. Look, there's my father, there's me, my husband, and there's mother's next to it. And there's brother-in-law. Keep family close together. There's sister-in-law. Toge. Little sister. There's Gita. There's Asta. David. Although I do not see Brynjolfr because he's in another court that we sent him over there down to the south. I'll hold court soon. We gotta settle a few things first. And that is, I am the ruling queen of all of Norway. Now it's time for you to join our nation. Peacefully. Without having a fight. Rightful liege. Timothy. Yes, you can join too, and we'll become friends as well. You up there. Since you're terrified, you'll likely join too. And yes, he will. And you. You will not join because recently waged war. Okay, I can understand that. We can improve relations with this. No, he wouldn't take an older woman. No, he won't. I mean, I would love to give him a concubine. Perhaps I can negotiate a release just out of goodwill. No, it doesn't improve his relations with me, no. But there's someone you do care. A Listen, I know you desire those lands back, but recently declared war. I can understand that. How much would it cost you? We can afford it. Right. So that's step one. Maybe we could be friends a little later. Because, you know, it's not good to be alone. So once everybody joins, we'll hold a grand vote. Two at the same time. I know you can't use the hook on that. Not only because we fought against the war some time ago, and he's paranoid. And the other areas that are did your part of Norway, such as this, they cannot join because the realm is remote. Same for Iceland, which honestly, I'd rather let Iceland be its own entity. Because there's a decision that anybody, any Norse culture, in fact, he's doing that now. He expanded there, now he's fighting a clash against that. That man could be the one to unite Iceland and form the all thing there. I'll let it be. Only focus on local affairs here. Now, let us hold a grand vote. Grand sacrifice. In Death Rebirth. Though smaller votes are held for many occasions through the year, once a decade, Hringja of Nordvaga, which is the Old Norse name for Norway, it's Nordvaga, come together for a grand celebration and most importantly the grand sacrifice. Though plentiful blood is shed for the gods, the meat of the offerings goes to the faithful. Such a rich feast usually makes for an incredible party. Of course, such an affair is expensive, and certainly not all the things need to be invited. Every lord and commoner in the ring is invited. I mean, you've got your new vassals, and this is a way to improve relations with your vassals by holding this sacrifice. That'll make everybody happy. And then after that, we hold a feast. And then we hold court. All in that order. And of course, make friends with whoever. Oh, speaking of friends. They made you a court jester? Oh, you poor woman. Making a chest. It's been sponsored. Oh, it's too late. It's too late. We'll have to get someone else then. I mean, which is a process that we're doing right now. The one who wants to forge a crown. If we can get her here, that'll be good. Of course you won't. Foremost there. Oh, the two Bjorns. A healthy rivalry between meddlesome fighters to be expected, but a growing discord between. Oh boy. Bjorn the Berserker and brother in law, and Bjorn, my father, is sour in the mood, of course. Bjorn is widely regarded to be more skilled. Which one? Okay. Brother-in-law Bjorn. Bjorn the brother-in-law. Is widely regarded to be more skilled. But Bjorn, my father, clearly takes issue with this decision. In the middle of an audience, the latter bursts into my throne room and clutching his sword out and cries, Bjorn! Only one of us can claim to be the Jotnik's most skilled dragon. Meet me outside, I'll settle this question. And then the other one here. Eon replies timidly. I would cut you to pieces where you stand if it was not for the presence of my lady, you lethargic oaf. Apologize and it may spare your life. I better act quickly if this escalation is to be halted. Normally we would go for this, but I don't want my father to die. Even though you gain a lot of court grandeur, but I'd rather take the lesser option. Take their swords. Give them training blades. You two are dear to me. Both of you. You should not kill each other. But at least you can hurt each other. But at least they'll be respected. So, court grandeur level increased to level 4 now for what we just did here. And it was this Bjorn that won this one, while the other one got wounded. I mean, the old age is starting to catch up to you, Father. And, you know, ever since we sent you on many raids, you've become a proper Viking, a well-known plunderer of foreign settlements. Plus, he's a siege engineer. Military engineer. Astas rewards. Another inimitable council meeting trundles on until my ears are suddenly picked up by my friend Astas' winsome tones. Urgent business, my lady. Nordvig is in dire need of a capable court tutor. Someone to properly ensuring your issue are given an education befitting their rank. A task Sturla has quite failed. Quite failed. She places her hand around. Of course, I'd be willing to take on this important burden of age. Here, Sir Harrick is clearly fuming. Court visits. I mean, you are the wisest of us all. This is just what I would call favoritism. Yes, it's time for Sturla to move over. Ásta will show how it's done. Now she is a tutor in addition to being a physician. I mean, are you sure this is the right decision? She is good in the aptitude. Alright, we bonded at the dance in Nidaros. What a good day. Also, you may have noticed that I am wearing a cape. Or a cloak. And so does my husband. We've only had one child, and we haven't had another one lately. And I still have the temptation. I'm thinking about seducing a certain someone, but... well, once I get better from being wounded, maybe I can try to help out here. He won't know. Hope nobody else will know, because I am considering seducing somebody who's got an inheritable trait. So that way, when I get pregnant, I will tell him that it's, you know, it's, don't worry, the child's yours. It's just sometimes we do gotta put in all that. Or alternatively, be friend of some other people. Oh my goodness! How did that happen? Oh yeah, you were the one that raided my land. I think it must have offered vassalization and it joined. They got this part that is supposed to belong to Norda. But unfortunately, I cannot fight against my friend. But perhaps when the realm is decentralized, as other children will be heirs to the land. That makes you more isolated down there. Future reference. A box, huh? A what? A Yazidi Kurd. Proper Yazidi. I was about to say, how do we have contact? Actually, no. Just you haven't clicked on it yet, dummy. Yeah, it's too far away to interact. Well, actually, put that diplomatic range on the inside. I'm trying to get this one in here. I hope she'll get better. Like to have her over here. Shy may be a bit problematic, but I don't think I should waste more time on this. Just trying to come up with ideas. All about ideas. Oh, yeah, they had a clash. My vassal were dealing with whatever issue that they were up to. What is this? What did I want? Take the hostage ticket will be released. Seize territory. That's what they want simply. What did I tell you about that? One second. Somebody in the diplomatic range in my realm, someone that, well, no, not like that, blasted somebody who's male and I'm looking for, is there anybody that has an inheritable trait? Besides my husband, as much as a genius he is, but I know there's someone who's Herculean. Kind of interested in that. Oh, don't tell me. I mean, you should be looking at your companions. It's like, we know who he is. Man's strong, but that's not inheritable. Oh, you can't do that. That won't work. Well, it's like, yes, you could seduce him, but it's doubtful that you're going to get a child off of him. Unless you're looking for a good time, and then you won't, and it will result that it will not get you pregnant. Are you going to be that kind of person? Are you really going to be that kind of person where it says it's like, hey, let me seduce you, and then there you go, and then he won't give me a job, but it's just if you want to do that for the fun of it, well, this is your purse, and he's the one that founded Greenland for us. Yeah, sure, why not? And then after that, I should, Oh, it's not even time yet. Oh, and another thing. Adopt special succession type. Partition succession makes us weaker divided. Perhaps the realm's magnates would accept the historical alternative. This is going to turn to Scandinavian elective. The question of who shall succeed me after my death has plagued me ceaselessly of late. The threat of splitting the realm ever on my mind. Of course, while it is usually difficult to persuade a realm to accept a new order of succession, it can be much easier to return to the old. The ancient ways of my people were the best, so we will gain Scandinavian elective succession. What that is the thing. Vassals swearing on title allegiance being a plus one. The ruler and all digital vassals except barons can nominate the title heir amongst the ruler's extended family and any available claimants. Voting power in this succession law is influenced by the elector's total domain development and capital popular opinion. So I know who to cast my vote for. Brynjolf. Because he's got the best skills. If I were to die suddenly, he should be the one to rule. My father's too old. Gita's not a great choice because she knows nothing but combat. Togir's not that notable. Not my mother. And not even a nephew. So Brynjolf should be the one. Makes the most sense. Accursed. Silversmith is silent as I pace around the horse-skin totem facing his quarters. It's bigger from every angle. He's right. It's definitely a knitting pole. A powerful curse that threatens his very life. The runes carved into its heart are indecipherable. The actual text of the curse is bold and striking. Confident in its righteousness, ending it on a hastily scrawled page. We have no witnesses and no evidence save for the curse pole itself. Is it because you are an Englishman and you feel that it's like nothing? A knitting is very, very bad. So am I going to assume that any one of these people could be a witch? Which, of course, that is criminal in our faith. So let me see. My brother's a cynic, but he's compassionate. That can't be him. Trausti is a berserker, but he's not that kind of person. He's fickle. He would change his mind. And if he were to have issues, he would tell it himself. Or even this man, the explorer. Vengeful he may be. If he were to say something about him, he would tell it to his face. Silversmith. Can't you see that it's all in your mind? There's a 74% chance that I'm going to talk him down and I'll get a wake hook on him as if I really need it. And I'll gain prestige. 25% chance that he suffers a mental break and then he thinks he's been cursed. And then he becomes paranoid. But regardless, you'll gain stress because I'm zealous. It's all in your mind. Oh, he suffers a mental break. Oh, I'm so sorry about you. He's been fatally cursed with a mythic bullet. They know their doom is coming. It's just not when. And a fearing is eating them alive. We both suffered a mental break, husband. I'm sorry. Oh, he's taken up drinking. While meanwhile, ruling has been such exhausting work as late. It's like no subject of another can wipe their arse without my express instruction. I was in the middle of planning a small getaway to a distant tourney with a reputation for particular fierceness. When a sergeant comes rushing up to me babbling about some new trivial catastrophe. Well, you like me well enough, so maybe I'll walk to my getaway. Yeah. Don't worry about it too much. He's taken up drinking. Because he's believed he's been cursed by the knitting pole. And this is gonna last 20 years. And he's paranoid now. I wish I could hug him. I tried to talk him down, but it didn't work. Although I would have still suffered a mental break and he wouldn't. But now, we both suffered. Ah, yes. Both can be both grand and small affair. By tradition, they include both human and animal sacrifice. Several prisoners will be offered to the gods, perhaps even including a special choice of my own. Their lives given in tribute to the gods. Though the beliefs that have done demand this, that there are some at court who are disgusted by this very idea, the ceremony can proceed with purely animal sacrifice, wish to avoid controversy. No. Only the finest of sacrifice will do, man and animal alike. So, we know who we're going to designate the chief sacrifice to, because we do have someone whose faith is evil to us. You there. You're up to be sacrificed. You're to be executed in 3 months. You shall be sacrificed, Christian, and all my stress will be going away. And then I can return to normalcy. It's high time for a raid. Oh, hold on here. Supply limit, that's the issue. Oh, this is the wrong place. You placed it wrong. You're supposed to place it where it has a higher supply limit. Get over here. We're gonna send you off to raid somewhere for you to get more loot. Help a little. You are a Viking, Father. Look at how much gold we could carry now. But it's doubtful that we could spend all this time. So what are they doing at home? Still fighting their independence war. Paris has still not yet recovered from the raids that we did. Has anybody disturbed Kent? Nah, somebody did. Crud. Well, where do we raid now? Jorvik hasn't been raided. There's some value there. Of course, the capital of Wessex too. But the realm has just been split up recently. So off you go, all of you. For some reason, I woke up about an hour or so. I usually do this morning. I find it hard to go back to sleep, and the sun's already rising above the horizon. Though I feel a little tired, perhaps I could take the opportunity to do something, as I have no essential work to take care of at the moment. Well, I'm still hurt, so I think it would be better to eat breakfast early. Eat some good food. Just make it sure. Should do that to a powerful vassal. Again, I'm seducing the explorers simply for the fun of it. At least we made a good little income out of that. So just raid in and around Jorvik. The guests at the Vlod are so numerous that they blanket the air around the temple, set up a cacophonous roar as Gilselbert is hauled up to the altar. in a very brief first and long line of men and beasts stretching up far out to the doors. Thrash ferociously as the hope of folk of the outdoor throttle his life away. The light in his eyes lasting until the first animal is slaughtered, human corpses to the hanging tree, animals to the cooking fires, all goers collected in a bowl. And Hofgadar use it to paint the walls of the temple, inside and out. Truly a spectacle worthy of the gods. To Odin, to Freya, to Njörn. This will lose all my stress because I'm zealous. And all that piety gained. Much better piety gained than last time, because this time you sacrificed somebody that's of a different faith than ours. And plus, every invited character higher opinion towards me, and every invited county to grant sacrifice. At least we're ready a little faster now. Wife, you better pay up. All good, except B's rather greedy, his old half-done white shirt. Keep going. Because I'm looking to spend money for a modest feast, which is just another way to increase the vassal's opinion towards me. Guests are gathered in the great hall, lords and ladies from the near and far reaches of Rome. The mood is bright and spirits are high as the feast begins. Welcome, friends. Only my two friends, Reynolf and Gida, didn't come. So the vassals are here, including my husband, the explorer, my mother, my brother, and my younger brother. Big feast. Though modest, but it's the best we could do. Oh, we'll raid Northumbria as well. It's such a joy to see my husband, Silversmith. Once we eat the drink and sing together, as if no time has passed since we parted last. We could have been dining in the barn, and this would still have been one of the greatest feasts I've ever been to. Ah, what life would be without him. I mean, to be fair, he's drunk, so he would live with this. Although, I feel bad about him still. I was married to a genius, and then he believes he's been cursed, and he is. We'll go up there. There's some valuables up there. We could all tell us that Magnus had too much to drink, even though he insisted on showing us how sober he was. Simply rising when he proved too much for him, and now I'm covered in stinking vomit. You ought to be ashamed of yourself, Magnus. Respect of homes, I'm proud to say the feast was a success. I have my husband to thank much for its success, and I feel nothing but gratitude to see the last few guests off. Till next time. Need to save a little money so we can hold court in case if I need to spend the said wealth on anything that issues may have to be resolved here. Are you sure you don't want her back? Sure, you'll change your mind. Hey, I respectfully decline because you vomited all over my clothes, and I don't appreciate that. Plus, there's a man I'm gonna seduce. Simply for the fun of it, because, you know... Listen. I know you're unable to give life, but at least you gotta have a good time for me, right? You can have him. Are you willing to join now? No. I'm still with the recently waged war. To Lindisfarne. That is the area where it was the very first Viking raid that happened on June of 793. Okay, we'll keep going up then. More loot up here, though. Obviously, Francia has much greater loot. But we've raided there recently. Actually, we found a new destination. If the war's still ongoing. Actually, no, it's about to be over soon. Never mind. I was thinking we should raid Flanders. There's a lot of development and loot in Flanders. Depths of passion. I need a private place to profess my love for David, the explorer. But where? It must be away from the prying eyes of servants. Courtiers, vassals, and family members alike. All walls are thin, so it needs to be someplace isolated, where few have access or good permission to go. And then the thought strikes me. The old catacombs. After sending a messenger to him, we meet in our secret place, deep beneath the earth, where we can be certain that we are alone. As I begin to describe my feelings to him, he interrupts me with a passionate kiss, one of many more to come. We are giving the ancients something to think about. I lay with him, but it's unlikely he's going to impregnate me because of who he is. After all, you're a discoverer of Freeland, and I don't know if you were a virgin your whole life, so just be glad. And don't tell anyone that we did this, okay? And we cannot be lovers, because why would we? Plus, there's only two secrets known to me, and I have no secrets, so gotta hide the evidence. And I am kinda tempted to seduce this man. I mean, he has a pregnant my sister, but he's got an inheritable trait. If he were to make me pregnant, and I got to lie to my husband, just say, you did this. I mean, after all, he's a drunkard. It could work. I can't believe I'm going to be doing this. I know you love your wife, but... Hey, you find me attractive because I am brave, aspiring blade master, novice hunter. And I am the queen. The drunkard. So perhaps there's room for improvement. Yeah, there is room for improvement. I know what to do. Just give me a moment while we continue to raid. Just only get as much loot as you can out of these lands. And I doubt that Ivar the Boneless, with whatever the size of the army has, can deal against us. Thank you. Bjorn Ironside's dead. Died in his sleep. So now it's Erika Bjornsson. Obviously it was born before 867. So it is an actual character. Disfigured. So now the realm is a little decentralized. That's good. Do you want her back? Greedy people, all of you. How do you love money more than your own spouses? What kind of people are you? So, okay, so here's what we're gonna raid this, raid that, and then the last one. Well, it's a smaller realm. Let's see, 9, 3, 0. Well, it's still taking, but okay, last few areas then. Then we'll go home. And then we'll bring an amount of money, then once you bring it all in, then we'll hold court. Can't believe I'm gonna be doing this. My husband's a paranoid drunk, so he don't know nothing. Hopefully he doesn't know nothing. He does know nothing. God dang it. You and your phrases. Important. Keep going. Future reference. Tempting as it may be, but keep an eye on that. One more place to raid and then you all go home. It's probably not gonna work, but Yeah, I fear that his advances to me is going to be rejected. Because he's in an army. That's why. Coming out to play. I'm sure Gita's relationship with her spouse Bjorn is a very happy and a productive one, but lately she has less and less time to spend with me, a dear friend. As their relationship deepens, every time I try to get her out for even as simple as a walk, she is apparently tied down with marital duties. I miss the good old days where we'd go out gallivating around the place, drinking the finest spiced wine until we threw up, and then doing it all over again the next night. What times! If only that wretched, worthless Bjorn wasn't keeping us from having that again. Including all the times that we slayed our enemies when we united the lands together. And occasional Frankish and English forces. Perhaps I can make them see the error of their ways. 90% chance that their relationship is irreparably broken where they divorce. 51% chance that a wedge is driven between them. 20% chance that neither of them are happy with me. And there's a 0% chance that I would push them too far where she and I are no longer friends. I'd be getting even more stressed, but regardless, I'm still gonna get stressed because I'm patient. Huh! Oh my goodness! They divorced her, given a wedge, and now they broke up. Wow. Well, so I heard you had a bad time. Now I'm stressed again. So it's like trouble at home? I didn't just register to them, now they're broken up, and yeah, you deserve someone better, honestly, you deserve someone better. And mind you, both of them were on a raiding trip, and now they have returned home. Alright, now let's hold the court. In order to be a successful ruler, I must actually rule on the various dilemmas and situations which arise in my sphere of influence. By officially inviting all my subjects to travel to my castle and petition me for aid, I'll be able to stay informed, sway the balance of power, and have visibility to show the world that I am in charge. This will increase my court grandeur. I'll invite my guest subjects to petition me for assistance. I might learn of exclusive opportunities. Might be able to influence situations in foreign realms. I might gain additional court grandeur. I might gain or lose opinion, prestige, gold, and more. Let's hear the petitioners. Sitting on my throne, I gesture for my guards to open the doors to the hall. A stream of people file in, some lining up in front of my throne while others move out of the way so they can simply observe proceedings. After several moments, all movement in the chamber has ceased. All faces turn towards mine expectantly. In front of me, I count three petitioners lined up in an orderly row, waiting for me to call them. Gesture for the first in line to approach. A shadow in the night. A woman who approaches my throne is clearly a commoner. My lady, she begins speech. I represent the local community of Nidaros. In the last few months, our cemeteries have been plagued with the disappearance of bodies, but all have been dug up and left no trace. At first we feared wild animals, or obscure powers at work. But then your own court physician, Ástríðr, was caught red-handed holding the dead away for experience. Please, put a stop to this blasphemy. You know she's my court tutor and physician. She knows what she's doing. Studying the human body is a sad necessity. Encourage grave robbing here. 15% chance he becomes a renowned physician for this. And yes, this will gain me more stress because I'm a zealous one. Now, serious business. A frightful peasant strolls all too close for a guard steps to us. Ooh! He packs over the wing, clanking, life through his scanty. Your ladyness, I come here from Nidaros with a matter of great importance. His eyes unite. Your seed, Trotning. A potter has been carving on with the cooper's wife, sister's cousin in the old village is in uproar. Incensed, Seven moves back, or where at eight, strokes his chin. I gotta get that popular opinion back up. No. Development. That's more important. Amateur Magnus, go fix it, please. Vestfold out of control. They're hanging us, hounding us. We could keep on, really. Please, we can organize ourselves without all the diff. A peasant woman from the Okay, Vestfold, an area plagued by unrest held by my brother, Brynjolf, who I appointed there. Assures me that control could be restored without unique undue bloodshed. He likes me well enough, so curious idea. Let's try it. I'll tell my brother to lay off the noose for a bit. This will benefit him in the long run. As the last petitioner departs, various courtiers follow him out of the room. I have business to attend elsewhere. Others remain, talking amongst themselves about the recent proceedings. Soon the ceremony and formality of the proceedings dropped away entirely, with the hum and bustle of normal courtly life taking its place. My business here is done. Stop right there. Get that stress down. One second. There we go. Now, you need to go work off some stress and go talk to a confidant. And if it's still not enough, go hunting. There's so much more to do around here. I'm in the middle of my training. When I spot my father, who also exercises, I look up and down. Not only does appear to be in good health, but also peak physical fitness. What I would love to measure my prowess against his, but in what way? Should I take multiple factors into account that I wish to win? Raw strength, or mix that could include stamina or wits? Old age is catching up to him. Oh, let's keep it even. Challenge him to a sparring match. Think of a mix of prowess and martial will lead to victory. Bjorn wins the challenge. He grew closer, forming a friendship with my father. He's doing fine still, health-wise. To truly be listened is a rare treat. Nothing eases mind like a good conversation with someone I can trust. Usually makes problems seem much smaller. Here. After a long conversation with him, I could feel his thoughts coming down. I was talking to Gita. This was just the way he said, now listen. I know what happened between you two. It was very unfortunate. I mean, you deserve someone better. Rock the boat. A vessel has offered me a usage of a pleasure barge upon a river, and I jumped at the opportunity as a perfect chance to get Bjorn, the ex-husband of Gita, alone to profess my strong feelings for him. We spend the afternoon in conversation on the deck, and after a pleasant dinner, we hang colored lanterns around the barge and dance under the stars to magic music. Bjorn tells us this is the best afternoon he's had in a long time. Thanks me. Almost unconsciously leads in for a kiss, which I gladly oblige. I could tell the slight look of shock when he realized what he has done, before a smile forms and another kiss comes. Before long, we are making love right there on the deck, lit by the lanterns and underneath the stars. After we finish, Bjorn lays on my arms, kissing my neck, and thanking me for this wonderful time. I feel a little queasy. Thanks, but again, only did this because hopefully my next child will have that strength. And my drunk husband shouldn't really know it. Ever. Right, now that's out of the way. Oh, you can become vassal now. Come in. Come in. You. I like to be friends with you, though it'll take some time. So we're gonna try to get her in, which will happen sooner rather than later. Would it not be wonderful if Svanhilda owed me, not out of fear, but out of gratitude? If I, for example, were to save her from vicious bandits while she was out trying. Indeed. Vicious bandits like the men currently waiting outside Castle Gate. I would charge with my guards at the last moment, drive them off, and leaving her life debt to me. So simple, yet so convincing. Come here. Now, forge me a crown. Now, you. Fabricate hook on net. Again, all this is just, it's only good if you were in the younger years, like if that's the first thing you were going to go for. I'm 38 and I don't have, I'm not going to become a seductress. Only did it just out of necessity. Hostile scheme success chance helps with the fabricate hook schemes. Will do. Grand halls instead of just the long houses. That will definitely work. My lady, the work on your precious artifact is proceeding very well. My beneficiaries, one another, is in a very good mood today. I'm not making any promises, but I've managed to produce two masterpieces. What would you like to guide my hand? To impress my whole court. Yeah, courtier's opinion up. That would be beneficial, in my opinion. As much as I like to do it for vassals, but that's just... Well, there's other means to impress vassals. Either befriend, play board games, seduce if you have to. Mm-hmm. And all that. Yeah, it isn't enough. You should go hunting right now. That gets rid of nearly all of your stress. Where exactly am I hunting? Oh, all the way up there. You would think it a creature from myth, perhaps a god in disguised an animal form. It was the largest lynx I've ever seen, even after the beast was wounded. Chase last half a day. It is still an imposing sight, lying dead before me. Its head will look beautiful in my great hall. I will receive a lynx hide court artifact. In Helgum. But Helgum is down there. Tanned hide of a lynx. The hide is of fine quality. Put that up on this side. Well, it's not visible, but it's there. Can't miss it. Got the links here. Someone else has established a Greenland estate. Oh, really? Peasant migration. It went from there, and now there's a large minority of the Norse people that actually moved into Sami lands. In fact, it's also the same up there. Large minority of them as well. Well met, Leech. I've heard tell your patron Sognsdal to the metalsmith. They say he's forged a crown worthy of a Jotun. Please take this and give it away. Wouldn't want to miss the chance to save the masterpiece. Yeah, you've done this before. For the regalia. Yeah. Now you're doing the same for my crown. $50 gold. Glad all is forgiven. Actually made a loss. And resilience and networks are still, you know, still going up. Who else has a family estate besides us? Was it you up there? You? Who else? Because you gotta look for the thing. No. There's an easier way to look that up. Struggle involved. Maybe I'll look through that screen. And these two are finally married. My youngest sister. My metal Sognsdal updates me on the progress. Drawing about the limits of mold as it envelops as my mind reels with bold ideas for my crown. Making may not be my personal forte, but that doesn't mean I can ever say how my money is spent. Zero percent chance that my ideas are poor. So my background gives me some unique insights. And my ideas work well. Damn well, better be. just remembered something else. If you want the court grandeur up, start adding positions. Of course, give the Sami woman the food taster position. Master of the horse shall be him. Master of the hunt, my brother. And a royal architect, Dog the Humorless. Asta, who is 80 and still in fine health. The cupbearer. Rat-free. Oh yeah, you got a cat for yourself. And apparently your room is rat-free, one would think. Oh, just give it to him. Well, there's one. See how this adds up. It'll go all the way up to 4. Wish we could get it up to 5. But you can't win them all. My dear friend grows caught wind of my desire to improve my standing with Perrine and offer me her aid. She assures me that she and Perrine are similar kinds of people. She knows precisely what I need to do to earn her trust. A hook on me. Well, what the hell are you going to do with that? I'll take the progress. As long as you just get things done. Let's just play a friendly board game. It's been a while since we've done one of these. Why would you honor that faint swan out of the court and not me? My courtier, Rogenfred, is livid. His parents is but certain that honor would follow in no one else. You wouldn't be a good seneschal. Oh, come off it. It's been a while since I've last played this board game. She takes seat opposite me, our little game of Anaphalat is about to begin, and a crowd about tells me how exactly how common my acquaintance is. She goes first, opening with an attempt at force so lavishly she almost brains herself. We're neck and neck, though neither of us are closer. You know, he's smiling. I may not be much of a talker, but I'm alarmingly good at this. Where'd you learn that board game? The Danes? Oh, she's good of entry. Okay. Don't go for Marshall. And my intrigue isn't as great as hers, so I'll say. If you try to move that piece, you're getting decked. Match marches on, continuing with a devious ruse that I'm left speechless. We're neck and neck, neither of us pulls me. Careful, Sergeant. One more move like that and you'll activate my trap piece. I gotta keep doing prowess all the way. Just gonna keep doing our best while I gotta do this. This isn't working. Arm wrestle for it? Match marches on. She's continuing with a decent move and a firm grip. Naturally, my techniques cunningly form out. I'm in the lead for now, though neither of us close victory. My opponent is silently still, frowning as she ponders how to swing her into the pieces. Gotcha. She took that personally. Oh, come on. Don't think of it. I'd love to play again sometime. Claudia, a commoner from Paris, is a complicated woman. I need to understand her as well as possible if I'm to convince people to take my side in upcoming arguments. She agrees it's a good game. See, what the hell are you talking about? I'll soon uncover the truth about her. People describe Claudia as both impressive and solitary, which tells you more about their relationship to her than anything else. Also, a curious number of people mention how often she smiles with cold attention and talks about court alliances. Not sure this information will be useful. But I just simply want her over here before they bring her in. Because I'd like to have some court artifacts. There, development level 3. It's going to take another 5 years before it gets up. I bump into the very grave looking Sognsdal, my metalsmith. I wonder if she doesn't bring ill news to the splendid crown she's ever in for. Oh, there you are, my liege. I hit a wall in my work. Nothing major. My ideas have gone to the ground as pressure mounts, she laughs nervously. I just need some inspiration, my Johnny. Might you have some prior examples I could examine? I know what you need. What fun we shall have. So, it's likely that nothing's going to happen or lose a bit of progress. Sleep, so that means nothing happened. You know, brother. One day, which is likely going to happen in the next episode, we're going to fight in a major war against them. Though, he's got allies. Well, one's within, and the other's from Prithenia. Prithenia, which is Prussia, which might be a little something. In fact, have a look at it. Well, actually, no, because we're trying to fabricate a hook on him. We can't afford to take a guess of how many troops are there. Unless we do a bit of scouting, which we might do then. And that'll be for next episode. My vassal, Jarl Dag, has honored me with a visit and has brought one of his courtiers along. Dag approaches excited. Well met, joining us today. It pleases me to see you thriving here in Nidaros. It's occurred to me that the Hala might be servicing your court. She's an incredibly talented scholar, the brightest I've learned from. I would make use of her myself, but alas, it doesn't seem possible. I would hate to see a great town go to waste. Would you take her in and unleash her potential? Is she much wiser than my old... Yeah, she is. Miracle worker. I know a place just for her. Stick around, you might be needed one day. Here's another way. Here. Just had to bribe her a little. Just say, hey, I want you to be my friend. Be my friend now. So we can bring you in. And then you can make a shield for me. I've been searching and searching. But Karina and I seem to have absolutely nothing in common. Without any common ground, how do we even begin to build a friendship? With effort. I will come to understand her. Now it's near guaranteed for success. Thank goodness for a court architect. Distracted by the first court, I'd let news from Smith to be delayed more and more. Now work has completely stalled on my crown. It seems I was not entirely to blame. I am told of her debilitating affliction, which leaves her often bedridden and in no humor for work. At last, I demand she's brought before me. Well, thank goodness you're stubborn. And from your culture, you tend to be stoic on such things. We just lost some progress again. No rush. See to things See to it that things get back on track. I want my crown, damn it! Concerning my life states, it's only natural that others should respect me. I'm convinced that Perrin also has accomplished a thing or two which fills her with pride. Perhaps she'll commission a small poem comparing our deeds to illustrate how we're both cut from the same cloth. Focus on her accomplishments. So therefore, I was finally able to spend some time with her. In the end, this is not a great hurdle for me to overcome and earn her. Trust and friendship, we both learned a lot of each other. I've been on our encounters, so much so that we parted as friends. We are closer than ever. Come here. Come to my court. Sponsor the inspiration, and you're gonna make us a shield. You know what, husband? I guess I didn't get impregnated by that man I laid back at that pleasure boat. Well, I guess I'm gonna have to do you again. If I want to have another child, this is our best opportunity to do so. Because I would like my second child to have an inheritable trait. Strong, smart, anything. Play my efforts to press fall and flat. A friendship with Eric. Is he really my friend? Predecessor's friend. Ah. I see. You're still standing on shaky ground. It's a mess. Oh, I got a brilliant idea. I'll have my friend add a dedication to the masterpiece he's making. Flattered dedicated to you will be deeply touched by my generosity, so I'll have no choice but to like me more. I mean, he's predecessor's friend, and therefore it's likely to become a friend. That's how this works. Yeah. Go ahead. But I still want that piece of land, so I could give it to brother. Because there's room for that. You got a son. Right. That's why we're voting for you. Because your line will live on. Mine probably won't if, actually will, because I do have a son. Rather charming. Gita's now a holy warrior. 1 second. My friend also stops in over the being song. Ah, there you are, Ástríðr. I just spoke to someone and heard she's cordial to Calvary. I couldn't resist a visitor shop. I talked to her about how you meet your expectations, and I think you will like the results. Oh, thanks, Asta. Oh yeah, we will end this episode when the crown is finished. Crud! As soon as I looked at that, it's been exposed. Curses! Even with that, it's still not enough. But don't abandon it. There's a chance we could try to improve it a little. We may never know you get an off chance that you succeed. And I make our way through the castle town in the dogs. As we come upon a square with a lovely fountain, we stop to take a bustling activity around us. Our entourage momentarily fade in the background. Remember the time we, so I think he'll truly value our friendship. Even though he's drunk, so I don't know if he remembers or not. He and I spent hours reminiscing about the past, playing out hypothetical futures together. The rest of the walk is tangled with an actable tone, and I cannot help but hope that some of our playful theories will turn into reality. He is truly a serene man. Over here, my lady. My beneficence one of the ways me over a wide grin. I've told many days and nights, but my work is finally done. She presents me with an object wrapped in cloth, and as I lift the fabric, my eyes grow wide. An ornate crown of masterful craftsmanship. The crown is forged from brass and set with small pieces of jasper. It's a masterwork headgear. This is lovely. Courtier and guest, if you'll be up a little more. There you go. It may not look like it now, but don't worry about it. As we will stop this episode right here on 888. So in the next year, in the next episode, well, I doubt this is going to work, but give it a try. Perhaps our paranoia found out. And we're going to have another artifact coming soon, which is a shield. And then I'm going to seduce my husband again, because I tried it with the others, but this isn't working out, so stick with the genius. I'd rather have a smart child than a strong child. Plus, I only have one child, and my brother has three, which is partly the reason why I said that it's better to vote for him. Interestingly enough, only my brother votes for his father. Everybody else is for... Oh, actually, one. No, they're not rivals. Train him and bring up... No. Nothing to do with it. So in that next episode, we will change our focus. Well, we'll probably go back to raiding soon, to somewhere. For more loot, to get whatever. And in a year's time, we'll support Greenland again. Yes. And at the same time, we continue our development. Because I know it's quite far away to get the development up to 10. Because it probably won't happen in Ástríðr's lifetime, but in future generations, that we will establish a Nordic ivory carving center. Which would be nice for here. But that's far, far into the future. So we hope you've enjoyed this episode, that we've united Norway and did other things and all that. So we'll see you in the next episode. But until then, so long for now.